Hi there, Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back and checking out my channel, the Candida Crusher channel. I talk about a whole wide range of topics on this channel. We're not just purely focused on Candida yeast infections. We also look at various other kinds of, you know, presentations, parasites, bacteria, gastrointestinal disorders, immune dysfunctions, adrenal problems, thyroid dysfunctions, many other issues we face, you know, in the clinic on a regular basis. Many of the Candida patients we see will have many of these kinds of conditions. But we also see people presenting with these types of complaints, obviously, who haven't got Candida. So let's now talk about a condition called Mast Cell Activation Syndrome, or MCAS. I've been asked quite a lot the past few months about what Mast Cell Activation Syndrome is. Is there any solution for it? You know, what does it cause? What problems stem from this condition? Is it common? Is it rare? How do we treat it? What diet? You know, et cetera, et cetera. So let's just give you a brief introduction first, what mast cell activation syndrome is. So previously, prior to this becoming quite a prominent syndrome, which it is today, we didn't really think of mast cells creating that much problems for people, apart really from perhaps, you know, being involved in parasitic, you know, infections. You know, these mast cells will be elevated, you know, or maybe anaphylactic reactions or allergy reactions. But what are mast cells? Well, mast cells are basically white blood cells, and they're found commonly throughout the body. But the most common places you'll find them are the connective tissue, the skin, the intestinal lining, the cardiovascular system, the nervous system, the reproductive organs. So these are small white blood cells. They're long-lived. They can live for a long, long time. And they live at the junctions, for example, you know, where blood vessels, right on the border of the blood vessel, right on the lining of the gastrointestinal lining, in the bladder, you know, in the heart sort of muscle, they'll live in areas very close to the border of that organ, you know, where it's going to open up into the body, for example. So these cells are very reactive cells, and they pick up on things very quickly, and then they're going to release chemicals into the lymph fluid or the bloodstream or wherever they are. They're going to release chemicals. And these chemicals are going to create actions in the body. So some of these chemicals include, you know, things with weird names like interleukins, for example, or cytokines. Right? So these chemicals initiate responses much further away than from, you know, from this mast cell. So you could liken mast cell a bit like the artillery in a warfare. You know, you'll shoot a missile somewhere, or you'll drop a bomb and you don't know where the target is, but you're going to create a powerful reaction far away from where you are. Whereas we've got other types of immune cells which tend to be more fierce hand-to-hand combat, like neutrophils or white blood cells, which are going to attack things that they can see. Whereas mast cells belong to a part of the immune system that can't really see what they're doing, but they release that chemical anyway. So I'm going to talk in some subsequent videos about the actions, you know, what these chemicals can actually produce in the body and what symptoms can be invoked from these chemicals. And then also we're going to talk further about what you can do on how you can prevent these kind of reactions to a high degree. We're seeing more and more of these mast cell kind of disorders in the past several years. And many people are putting it down to environmental toxins, molds, stress, you know, overpopulation, crowding of the planet. But more and more people I'm seeing in my clinic are presenting with immune dysfunction. And I would absolutely agree. I would put it down to stress, poor diet, time poor, nutrition poor, you know, all these factors. We'll talk a lot more about that in a subsequent video. So this is going to be a series on mast cell activation syndrome. Thanks for tuning in.